بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم نحمده ونصلي على رسول الكريم أما بعد Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has given us opportunities upon opportunities to find Allah, to find the love of Allah, to connect with Allah, to link ourselves with this Allah. The system of the world is there to overpower man, to overpower his heart, so his heart does not remain connected with Allah, but now moves with the connection of the creation and dissipates with the connection of the Creator. So how cheap is love that it can be bought nowadays? There's a price for love. If you don't give me a Valentine's present, or you don't take me out for my anniversary, that's a sign that you don't love me. How cheap is love that it can be bought? What kind of love it will be, that this love depends upon gifts for its survival. Its survival will be based on gifts. On your son for 2 days of the year and you love them, 363 days of the year spend with somebody else. How deceiving is this love of the dunya? Sometimes we give the present, it's not good enough. You don't give the present, you're not good enough. Likewise, what kind of love is restricted to one day in the entire year? Somebody doesn't give the gift, they're not a good husband, they're not a good spouse. What kind of love it may be that it breeds hatred, jealousy, and deprivation for many? And those that didn't get it, what about them? The psychological trauma. Deen has come with a solution for every era, for every society, till the day of Qiyamah. It is up to the people of Iman to decide. So that's why we should not get caught in the trap of deception of Shaytaan. And Nadhru Salmon, it is an arrow from the arrows of Shaytaan, that Cupid, that bow and arrow of Iblis is pointed to us 24/7. We have to check ourselves, we don't get caught and become the hunted. Somebody during Valentine's Day told his friend, I bought my wife a matching bag and a belt for Valentine's. And in the same breath, he said, she should be able to fix the vacuum cleaner and get it running now. Vacuum cleaners need bags and belts. Somebody else said, my wife told me for Valentine's Day, nothing would make me happier than a diamond necklace. So he said, I got her nothing. Nothing would make me happier than a diamond necklace. So everything seems rosy, but it's not rosy at all. It's actually rocky. This is just a cover-up. Anniversaries are just a cover-up. Everyone is living a double life. If you look at every aspect and dissect it, in Western culture, the significance of the red rose dates back to the Greek mythology and the belief that the red rose was created by the goddess of love, Aphrodite. And according to their legend, the flower grew from the ground watered with Aphrodite's tears and the blood of her ill-fated lover, Adonis. Here they are talking of gods, na'udhu billah. It is a form of shirk. وَيَغْفِرُ مَا دُونَ ذَلِكَ لِمَنْ يَشَاءُ. Allah will forgive everything, but Allah will not forgive shirk. So one is the roses, one is the chocolates. We want them to look like supermodels, but we're making them and giving them sweets and chocolates to lose their figure. Likewise, it's all about indulgence, pleasure, intimacy. Because that's what it boils down to. Then gifts are given. A bear is a violent, dangerous animal, where a person in his normal senses would not go near the bear. How much propaganda we must have been through where we believe that bears depict love and affection, and bears can be hugged. How much propaganda and deception that we keep toys and pictures of mouses, Mickey Mouse and Donald Duck. If it was a real life rat in the room, what would have people done? Likewise, red. Psychologists have discussed in detail the psychology behind the color. Red is the color of fire and blood. It is associated with war, anger, danger, power, passion, desire. So it's an emotionally intense color. It enhances human metabolism, increases respiration rate, raises blood pressure. So it's got to do with fire and blood. Blood is death. Blood is sacrifice. Either we sacrifice our blood for Allah and His Rasul. Qurbani is sacrifice. Oh, we sacrifice in ourselves for the wrong avenues, Iblis and us. Or it depicts fire. And fire is Jahannam. Does amal, does action, will it take me closer to Allah or take me further away from Jannah? Coca-Cola's brilliant is red to stimulate emotions, to stimulate the heart rate. Even in courts and saints, they use it. He's in the red, means he's close to bankruptcy, he's in financial problems, he's seen red, he's in a rage, he's caught red-handed, somebody's doing something wrong. So red has connotations of danger, destruction. You've given this red rose to your beloved. What does it signify? Was an amal of shirk from our origin of a mushrik, ascribing partners with Allah, and then this. Then immodesty, immorality, money making. The planned Valentine's Day spending in the US alone is expected to reach $22 billion. We are just a bait. The U.S. Greeting Card Association estimates approximately 190 million Valentines are sent each year in the U.S. A staggering 250 million roses are produced for Valentine's Day every year. How many poor people could have been fed? How many stomachs could have been filled? How many shelters could have been built? How many orphans could have found some solace? And if the Hussein, that the so-called Valentines worked, then look at the statistics. The World Health Organization indicates that 1 in 3 women worldwide have experienced physical intimate partner violence or some sort of violence. And some national studies show that the number can be high as 70% of women. 137 women are killed by a member of their family every day. It's estimated that 87,000 women were internationally killed in 2017 globally. More than half, 50,000, were killed by intimate partners or family members. And more than a third, 30,000, were intentionally killed by their current or former partner. So if this Valentine's formula was working, then the figures show something else. Adult women account for 49% of all human trafficking victims detected globally. Women and girls together account for 72%. And most of the women and girls are trafficked for sexual exploitation. Many are forced, many are abducted. What zulm, what oppression. Likewise, 1 in 10 women in the European Union have reported or experienced cyber harassment since the age of 15. And if we think so, this occasion is worth celebrating, then let's go into the history of Valentine, or Saint Valentine. So say he was a priest in the 3rd century in Rome. The Emperor Claudius decided that single men are better as soldiers more than wives and families. So he outlawed marriage for young men. Valentine, realizing the injustice of the decree, defied Claudius, and he performed marriages in secrecy. When he was discovered, an order was put for his death. So, rumor has it and is mentioned that Valentine actually sent the first Valentine greeting himself after he fell in love with a young girl, a jailer's daughter, who visited him during his confinement. And before his death, it is alleged that he wrote a letter signed, "From your Valentine." So those people who prefer to follow these customs are only destroying their love, they are not making their love. Others say that St. Valentine's feast day is in the middle of February because they Christianized the pagan celebration of Lupercalia. So that was initially on the 15th of February. It was a fertility festival dedicated to the Roman god and the Roman founders. So to begin this festival, members of the Lupercalia, an order of the Roman priests, would gather at a sacred grave. In this cave where infants, the founders of Rome, are believed. So Lupercalia is from the origin of a wolf. So they were killed by the so-called shield. And the custom would be that the priest would sacrifice a goat for fertility and a dog for purification. They would take the goat's hide, stuff it into sacrificial blood, take it to the streets, and they would slap women who welcomed that for fertility. But as legend has it, the Romans were romantics and drunk, and nudity was the order of the day. The bachelors would choose a name and become paired with a chosen woman, and that would end up in evil actions. So it was an attraction, and we call it a lottery of distributing young women to young men for entertainment and pleasure until the next year's lottery. So a matchmaking lottery, a fest of zina, adultery, fornication. So Christianity, when it came in, decided to outlaw this custom, and they declared February 14th Saint Valentine's Day. And then it became synonymous again with love, so it reverted. But even France and England, on February 14th, they banned this culture. Why? Because of this, the troubles accompanied with the lottery, The French government banned this practice in 1776, Italy, Austria, Hungary, Germany. Likewise, in England it was banned also in the 17th century. So it wasn't a day of romance. But the Christian church, to replace this evil act, they changed the lottery from the names of women to the names of saints. And you would choose the name of a saint and impersonate that saint for the rest of the year. So they believed that they wanted to preserve good through an evil habit, through evil means. And history today proves they failed. Likewise, the people of Deen, the people of Haq, if they try to promote good and Haq in any other means of evil, then the consequences will be the same. Imam Maalik rahmatullahi say, the latter part of this ummah will not be reformed. Islam will never be made if it is not done like how Janabi Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam reformed the first part of this ummah. So, it is a powerful lesson for Muslims that this was an event of behayai, immodesty, shamelessness. And remember that arrow of Iblis, the Cupid, which they call it. So, shooting an arrow will make them fall in love. But this love is the love of Ghairullah. They're talking about the Roman god of love and beauty, the Cupid, the picture in the Valentine's card. And this is all Greek mythology, which is entrenched with shirk and batil and falsehood and immodesty. Likewise, Eros was playing with the emotions of the gods and men, used his golden arrow to incite love. That's Iblis. Say, I fell in love. You fell. The word fall in love means you fell. This heart is only for Allah. Channel the love to Allah and to the creation of Allah. Likewise, roses. Venus, the goddess of love, and rose was a favorite flower. Again, and again in history, Valentine's Day could be celebrated. If you look at it, February 14, Roman Catholic calendar, then Saint Valentine on November the 3rd, or traditional Valentine on January the 7th, or female Saint Valentine, July 25th, or the Eastern Orthodox Church, July the 6th, July the 30th. So, inciting relationships and connections, which is out of the bounds of Sharia. So, immodesty, intimacy, passion, that's the avenue, and Allah has made it halal. Likewise, the shabu and imitating the kuffar. فَخَالِفُوهُ خَالِفُ الْمُشْرِكِينَ Malik Samir said, oppose the mushrikeen. Lengthen your beard, shorten your mustaches. Likewise, sumu yom ashura wa khalifu fihi al-yahud. Even in good, we are told not to imitate him. When Nabi alayhi salam came to Medina Munawwara, they were celebrating ancestral heritage. Inna Allah qad abdalakum khayran minhuma. Allah has changed it for something better. Eid. So these occasions are occasions of destruction for Iman and detriment to Iman. That's why we need to be careful. Where we spend our wealth, israf, extravagance, wastage. Talking about Valentine's Day, they say three wealthy men were sitting one day. The first said, I love my wife so much, I got her something that goes from 0 to 100 in 4 seconds. The other men, they were confused. So he said, I got her a white sports car. The second person says, you know what, I love my wife so much, I got her something that goes 0 to 100 in 2 seconds. So then they were wondering, what car is that? He said, it's a Ferrari, smiling. So last person, also with a big smile to the whole conversation, says, that's impressive. But I bought my wife a car, something goes from 0 to 200 in 1 second. So they said, impossible. Not possible. So he says, it is. My wife was overweight. So I bought her a scale. I bought her a scale. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala give us tawfiq of realizing the value of time, the value of this amanat of life, the value of this amanat of wealth, and give us tawfiq to utilize it in the right avenues.